self. I see a man. And a woman. I see a man. Which one? There's a man. His wife. Two and four children. A man, his wife, four children. Plants a seed in the ground. Wipes the sweat of his head. To wet that seed in the ground. Then he waits. Watches. For that seed to grow. Little does he know. The earth runs dry. His sweat runs dry. The seed you sow doesn't grow, not as well as last year. The rice he sells brings home much less. Got to borrow just a bit. Ittasa konchu kottiga indo korchu panam therum therum eppa thana then he walks this way that way he walks. Got to look for water. Got to feed that four. Of course, in the middle of all this, he falls ill. No pill, a prescription, a doctor, a bed, a hospital. 45,000 rupees for 4 days. Better stay out than in. Bit more, huh? Pull the child out of school. Save that money. Bond him. Bonded labor. The daughter, Sujata, she doesn't need to get married today. Postpone it. Save the money. Next morning, she hangs herself. Bit more. Well then. If you can't take it anymore, just snuff it out. One man down, one woman to go. Hey God, one bead of sweat to wet this child's mouth. Yedu kundala sami, yekaruna maya, yenni metlikna, kana de ye maya. I can't hear her. Can you hear her? No, I'm sorry, I don't know where she is. I saw her some days ago. Maybe in the marketplace, I'm not sure. The boy? Not seen in school? Ask, find out. I must move on. Yes, yes. I've got to go. Due north, northeast, I can hear the distant roll of the hills. Far away, the river Brahmaputra roars. The skies are dark. The clouds hang low. Shanti live here?
No.
Not at home? Oh. Gone out? To the market? Yellow sari? Red border? Child in hand? That way? Rice fields. Down this way. Child is back. He says nothing. In fact, nobody says anything. No one has seen anything. Except 11 women who step out in the open. Bearing her anguish. knowledge, bearing all, bearing her pain. I must move on. Further north, northwest. Hello. Does Sharmila live here? Not at home? You don't know when she'll be back? She lies on a hospital bed, half asleep, half awake. Year one. Iram Sharmila, age 33, has been on hunger strike since October 2000. She fights against the imposition of martial law. Close to death, she fights for the right to live. Year two, Iram Sharmila is hospitalized. She is force-fed through the nose. She still refuses to eat. Her crime? Attempted suicide. Year three. Sharmila drags her feet just a little. I do a bit of yoga to keep body and mind together, she says. Year four. She is released but immediately remanded again into custody. She still refuses to eat. She must be forced fed. Year five. Her mother hasn't seen her for 5 years. If I visit her in hospital, she will break down. I don't want that to happen, so I don't go. Year six. Even as we sit here, Iram Sharmila lies on a hospital bed in Delhi. She still refuses to eat. Iram Sharmila breathes. Her heart beats. Munia, the construction worker, who has... She's built so many homes. She still doesn't have a roof over her own head. I would.
Open my eyes. Down that road.
You know that bend in the river? That road we go down together? Tell me your name. Can I write your name? Will they read it in the papers tomorrow? Will they? Here it is. I've saved it for you. Nothing's lost. I've picked it out. Hold on tight. Here it is. Just hold my hand and don't let me go. Wipe that sweat off your face, that blood off your face, and no, I won't let it. Oh, I won't let it come. Here, see, there's nowhere. This time we'll get it right. You recognize these places? You've been here? You've built here? Right. Jasper. No, no, there's nothing to worry. See that vast expanse of a building. We're home. Yeah. That's your new home. Steady. Steady, steady. You'll get used to it. It takes time. Finally. Finally, the right people in the right places. That's how they welcome you. So many of us. So many of us build a home away from home. You must take charge of this one. It's yours. All the words in my pen were never enough to describe you. It's all yours now. Write your own story. Leave them be for now. They're tired. Let them be for a while. Till tomorrow. For now, it's time to sleep. Rest. Sleep.